20 years, I feel like maybe the world will have flying cars. People wouldn't have to go out to buy stuff anymore. It could just be mailed to them. It would be very fun, and technology everywhere.
What we're seeing here is the evolution of education.
The thing that excites me most is I grew up in this area. I know a lot of the families still. And this program, what is happening here at FDR, is changing the trajectory of a lot of kids because they have the opportunity to use technology in a way that they didn't before. So things started transforming for us a few years back when we received a grant from Verizon.
For the ship being this small, it will take 4.5 hours just to print. The little ship I created in a website called Tinkercad.
So it's the Wharf 1812. So some kids are creating a VR experience around the wharf. You're creating the ship here. They're using technology to actually respond to the assignment that the teacher has given them, and they're creating all different products using what they've learned in this lab.
In the beginning, it was really hard. How will you know that they learned something? And once you give them that freedom, that's terrifying at first, but then once they start trying that, there's joy. And it looks a little chaotic because you're not in rows and people aren't raising their hands. You need to be prepared to walk by a room and say, that's learning because I see everybody's engaged and they're producing something.
It has to have a clean surface in order for it to print out.
Kids' attention spans have reduced over the last few years with access to the internet. So it's different from when maybe I was in school 40 years ago, where you had to learn through a textbook. You had one instructor at the front of the room. With gaming and other experiences that they're having, we have to also bring those experiences into the school system because that's what gets them engaged. And that's what we do with the lab and with the technology that we bring in schools.
When we first started this program, we didn't have IT in the building to support this. A Tiger Tech is a student tech leader who supports technology, our school, and our district.
We started as a tech program because Verizon gave us a grant. They wanted to find out what would happen if we integrated technology with education. So I was part of the first generation of that. So I always come back, even though I graduated 5 years ago, because I always want to help, because I feel like it's a part of me now.
Devin actually has a clue about a lot more technology than I do, and coding, and engineering, and physics.
Maybe we should move this over to the disk, and maybe that'll work.
If it doesn't open in this, we're probably just going to try to just put it into the 3D printer and see if it just works.
I think the biggest technology out there right now is VR, and how VR and AR is evolving fastly, too. It's important to be fluent in technology because there's no way to escape it. We're going into a future where technology is going to be a part of every aspect in life.
So when you think about the workplace of the future, it's a place where you need different skill sets. Mundane tasks are going to be automated. The tasks where you're able to memorize certain things and sit at a desk all day, that workplace is not going to be existing. We're disrupting education. Education doesn't change very rapidly, but we partner with schools and districts and teachers to bring these types of innovative practices so that we can make those changes working alongside them.
Being human is going to be the best resource we have. Our brains are meant to create, and we're meant to connect to people.
A building, a room, a place can be a catalyst, especially for the students that we're trying to reach.
Can you imagine if you have a whole generation of kids growing up loving learning, loving technology, loving science, loving exploration? You have happy people. You have people who are willing to make the world better.